In this lecture, I'll complete the previous part where I had taken the interesting aspect of the rotational motion up the plane when a disc or a sphere or a thin shell, whatever, is placed at the bottom with certain angular velocity with zero u. I'll just briefly recapture it. So initial u is zero and omega is omega I, and it is placed here. It is given that mu cos theta is greater than sine theta is given to you. Now let us see what are the forces which are working on this. Let us draw the free body diagram. It's always advantageous to draw the free body diagram. Draw like this. Now this is your theta, and the parallel to the surface is mg sine theta, is along the parallel, along the line which is parallel to the surface, and your mg cos theta is like this, and this becomes the normal reaction. And here, when the body is placed with certain omega with no initial velocity, it will start slipping immediately. So slipping will start, and then it will catch up. This velocity will start increasing and omega will start reducing because it is working against the friction. So when the slipping starts, we apply the value of friction. So the friction force will be equal to mu times n. Friction force, we will write mu times n only when the slipping is taking place. When pure rolling starts up the inclined plane, I'll come to that, then please do not put this value. F as mu n is not to be put in pure rolling, because this mu n is the maximum friction force. F maximum available is mu n. For example, if I have a plane surface and I place a body here, I push it with certain force F1, and the weight is mg, and your normal reaction is n. So the maximum friction force which this floor can provide you here is mu times n, or mu mg. This is maximum. So till such time your F1 is less than F maximum, the resulting force here is not this, but only F1. So like in case of these simple bodies, when you try to push it, till such time you exceed this value, till such time you reach this, up to this value, you will not be able to move, and it will oppose only your force. It will not give more than your force, otherwise body will start moving backwards. So be careful in such situations where, suppose it is asked that force F1 is applied and F1 is less than, it is given that F1 is less than mu n, and you are asked to tell what is the normal reaction here, frictional force here. So frictional force will be only F1. Do not write F is equal to mu n in such situation until the slipping starts. Once the slipping starts, you can apply F is equal to mu k n. But till such time you are able to apply the full force to overcome this, do not put friction force as the maximum friction force. So same thing is here. This is the maximum friction force which is available to you, and this was the dilemma which I was in the previous lecture I was covering. So when you take a slipping case, you use F is equal to mu n. When you take pure rotation, do not put this mu value here. This is maximum. So just for the cost, at the cost of repeating, I am repeating because it is an important point. Now let us solve this problem. What happens here? Now the rotation is in this direction initially, and no velocity is there. So it is slipping, it will try to push it forward. So the friction force will act against the rotation, and it will basically start giving it velocity. So your acceleration upwards will be equal to F minus mg sine theta, and here you will put F is equal to mu mg cos theta, or F is equal to mu n. This is nothing but n, because your slipping has started. You are consuming the maximum available friction force. So your acceleration is ma, sorry, acceleration is f upon m minus g sine theta, or is equal to mu g cos theta minus g sine theta. Condition which was given is mu cos theta is greater than sine theta. It is required also, otherwise your body will not move upwards. So if you are asked what is the condition that if body is put without initial velocity but with certain angular velocity, what is the condition that it should start moving and achieve a pure ruling? So this is the condition. This has to be positive. Until unless your A is positive, it will not be able to move upwards. So now this is your equation for high take g common. It is mu cos theta minus sine theta is my acceleration. Now see what is the torque acting on it. The torque which is acting on it, let me draw here to save space. Now this was the position of the body. It is omega, and force is acting like this. So the torque will be F into R. Now this torque will retard the angular velocity, and angular velocity has to come down and this velocity has to increase, as I showed in the previous graphs. When your omega R is some value and U is zero, they both have to meet at a point for pure ruling to start. So your omega R is basically going down. So the retardation here which we get is torque is equal to I alpha. Alpha here is retardation we are taking. So torque is F into R. And suppose it is a case of a disc, then I is mr square upon 2 into alpha. So alpha is twice F upon mr, or this is your alpha. Now we want to reach a point where the pure ruling will start. Means I will, after certain point of time, I'll reach a certain value Vf and omega f, such that Vf is equal to omega f into R. Now I'll reach that value. Now, simply apply your equations like V is equal to U plus At, and omega is omega initial plus alpha t. We will use these equations suitably, correcting the sign. Negative in case of retardation, here it will be retardation, here it is acceleration. So my V final will be U was zero for linear translational motion into A is this G mu cos theta minus sine theta into T is my V final. And what is my omega final? Omega final will be omega initial was given as omega minus, because it is retarding, the torque is acting against the rotation. So minus alpha t. So alpha is twice F upon mr into t. Put the value of F here. You can put the value of F suitably, because you are consuming the maximum friction force. Mg cos theta is the value, and into t. So this becomes mm gets cancelled. So your r omega f is equal to omega r minus twice mu g cos theta into t. Now what is this value? This is nothing but v final. This is v final. So I can equate these two equations and I get the value of t. So g mu cos theta minus g sine theta into t is equal to omega r minus twice mu g cos theta into t. So I get value of t as 3 mu g cos theta minus g sine theta is equal to omega r. So my value of t is, my value of t, let me write here, value of t is omega r upon, means after this much of time I have reached the pure ruling situation, cos theta minus g sine theta. Now this much of time has elapsed. I can now, when time is available with me, I can find both. I can find the velocity final. So velocity final is time times acceleration. It is g mu cos theta minus sine theta upon 3 mu g cos theta minus g sine theta into omega r. It was omega r g sine theta, g mu cos theta minus sine theta times t, and value of t, I have simply put the value of t, which is omega r upon 3 mu g cos theta minus g sine theta. So I have got the value of v final, and omega final will be g mu cos theta minus sine theta into omega upon g will get cancelled actually, 3 mu cos theta minus sine theta. So I have got the value of v final and omega final. Now after having reached here, pure rolling is starting. When pure rolling is starting, you can easily apply the energy conservation formula. Just apply the energy conservation formula. Initial energy here means rotational and translational energy. I can find out what height it has reached. I can also find out what is the height when it has started the pure rolling. This can easily be found by v square is equal to twice as. We know the final value of velocity. So I can find the what was the value of the height h1. Now to find where it is to reach after pure rolling is actually h2. So you will be crossing from h1 to h2. So take the energy here. You can now solve it like this. For pure rolling, there are two methods. And before energy method, let me explain another thing. When you are here where your pure rolling has started, you have to apply. Now my pure rolling has started. This is my V final and omega final. It is going upwards. It is consuming energy. So its velocity has to come down. When its velocity is coming down, omega final also has to come down. So omega final has to come down means there has to be a friction force which has to be in upward direction opposing omega. But this friction force will not exceed g sine theta. Your net force will be mg sine theta minus f. And if you commit a mistake of putting f is equal to mu cos theta, then it is wrong. If I put mg sine theta and f is equal to minus mu mg cos theta, if I put there, it is wrong. This is f, not, and this is f maximum. This is to be used when your slipping is taking place. But here you are using as much force as it is required to keep it moving upwards. So do not commit that in the previous lecture which I mentioned, because what is happening if you put this, your mu g cos theta is greater than sine theta. It was given, the initial condition means your net force is upwards. If you put like that, net force is upward means it will keep on moving forever. That cannot happen. So it is not using the full frictional force. Be careful when you apply pure rolling motion on the inclined plane. The friction force is to be used as F. Do not put the value as mu mg cos theta. You only put the value as mu mg cos theta as mu minimum required. Mg cos theta. If you, question is, you have to tell what is the minimum frictional force required to have a pure rolling motion. I'll cover that also in a separate lecture. Then you put mu minimum. Means this is the minimum value of friction coefficient which is required. It doesn't mean that you will use the maximum value of friction coefficient, which is the friction coefficient which is available to you. Suppose the friction coefficient available to you is 0.4. And for pure rolling motion up the inclined plane, I will separately derive it. Suppose you require 0.2. So your friction force here is determined by this mu minimum, which is required. So that is why I am again repeatedly telling you, please do not use mu, which is given to you, and write this equation. You have to use only as F. So I use F here, and then I solve it further. So net force is your backwards, so your retardation is G sine theta minus F upon M. And what is your alpha? Means the retardation for the angular, for the rotational motion, MR square upon 2 is your I alpha, and torque is FR. So your alpha is F upon twice MR. And in this motion, your A will be equal to R alpha. It's a pure rolling motion, so your acceleration, translational acceleration, has to match your rotational acceleration. Otherwise, slipping is happening. So here you put A is equal to R alpha. So your R alpha is equal to F upon twice M. R alpha is F upon twice M, and this is your A. So F upon twice M is equal to G sine theta minus F upon M. So your 3F upon M is equal to G sine theta, or your F upon M is G sine theta upon 3. Now, if you are asked to find out what is the minimum value of frictional force required for this pure rolling to happen, now you put F is equal to mu minimum mg cos theta upon m is equal to g sine theta upon 3. So here you get mu minimum is equal to tan theta upon 3. Is the minimum mu required, if that is a question. Now that is not the question. Right now I want to solve it for finding what height it will reach. Energy method is very straightforward that you can apply, but I wanted to cover this approach also so that the concepts are clear. Now I have got the value of F upon M, so my retardation is G sine theta minus G sine theta upon 3, which is twice G sine theta upon 3. This is my retardation. And my initial velocity was given here. Whatever was the final here, U initial is, what was the U final given when the pure rotation was had started? I'm not putting the value. Value we have already found. Now from this, we can find how much distance it will travel. And please see, distance traveled here will translate into, if this is s, this will be s sine theta. So please check whether you have to find the height or the distance. The formula which I am applying is for the distance, because I am solving everything on the inclined plane. So v square is equal to twice as, you use twice as, and your finally the answer will be Vf square is equal to 2 into 2 g sine theta upon 3 and into s. So you get the value of s as 3 upon 4 Vf square upon g sine theta is the value of s. And what is the value of height is h sine theta. So height will be 3 upon 4 Vf square upon g. Now let us see whether it matches with your energy formula or not, which is very straightforward. And there, for energy formula, I will like to tell you one basic point. When you apply rotational and translational motion, just adopt one method is straight, half mv square plus half I omega square. Let me do this also, and then I will tell you a slight short trick. And it's not a trick, a short method. So let me apply this. Now it was a pure rolling thing where Vf was equal to R omega F. So I can put omega F is equal to Vf upon R. I'm not putting those values. It will lead to complicated. Idea is to tell you the concepts. So it is half mv square plus 1 upon 2. What is the value of I is half mr square, and omega square is vf square upon r square. So it is 1 upon 2 mv square plus 1 upon 2 into 1 upon 2 mv square. This is also vf. Vf means what was vf here? Here actually vf dash here will be 0. Now it is half mv square into 1 plus 1 upon 2, which is half mv square into 3 upon 2. So half mv square into 3 upon 2 will be equal to mgh. So your height will become 3v, this was v final square upon 4g is your height, the same value which we got by this formula. Now here also, instead of doing so much of calculation, try to use this method, is that half m, it is for pure rolling cases only, v square multiplied by a value which is 1 plus the coefficient of the moment of inertia. Use this formula. So if it is a disk, it is mr square upon 2, sorry, it is 1 upon 2 for disk, for solid sphere 2 upon 5, for shell 2 upon 3, for ring 1. Simply put value of c here and then use, this is the total energy. It includes both rotational and translational energy for pure rolling cases. So this way, had I put in case of disk c was 3, so it is c was 1 upon 2, half mv square into 3 upon 2. So I get 3 upon 4 mv square is equal to mgh. M gets cancelled, so h is 3 v square upon 4 g, the same value which we have got. So by this lecture I have tried to cover various aspects. I have gone a little bit fast, but sorry for that if it was fast.